Hello students, today we are going to read the essay by Chesterton on the pleasures of no longer being very young. Chesterton again was a Victorian essayist. Mainly he was a journalist, and the tendency of his was to write for amuse, to show off his wit. He was born in the year 1874 and died in 1936. The chief aim of his writing was to give a kind of shock to his readers by showing his wit and by showing by writing those paradoxical lines. This essay is taken from the essay series All Is Grist. It was published in 1931, and in this essay on the pleasures of no longer being very young, Chesterton talks about the we can say the difference between the young and the old. What pleasures, what benefits, what we achieve in the young age, and how we look at the things in the young age, and how they become realized later on in the old age, in a very witty, humorous, and paradoxical manner. Chesterton has quite made it clear that what are the differences, what are the pleasures, in his own words, what are the pleasures of being old. So the essays about this difference of age कि चेस्टर्टन जो है वो इस ऐसे में अपने examples के through, paradoxes के through, और very witty remarks के through, so many proverbs are there, उनके through वो ये बताना चाह रहा है कि जो old age है उसमें और जो young age है उसमें क्या difference है, कौन से benefits हैं, कौन से pleasures हैं, कौन सी वो चीज़ें हैं which we are able to get in the old age only. So the essays that there are advantages in the advance through middle age into later life which are very seldom stated in a sensible way. Generally they are stated in a sentimental way, in a general suggestion that all old men are equipped with beautiful snowy beards like Father Christmas and rejoice in unfathomable wisdom like Nestor. It says there are advantages in the advance through middle ages into later life. Obviously, it is quite obvious that when we cross one stage of life and enter into another stage of life, then we have many advantages. It is quite obvious. उनका कहने का मतलब है जब हम जीवन के एक पड़ाव से दूसरे पड़ाव में प्रवेश करते हैं, जब हम उम्र का एक जो हमारी अवस्था होती है उसको छोड़ के जब हम दूसरी अवस्था में एंटर करते हैं, देन ऑब्वियसली वी हैव मैनी ऑप्शंस, मैनी एडवांटेजेस, मैनी न्यू थिंग्स विच आर बीइंग गिवन टू अस, विच आर बीइंग अचीव्ड बाय अस. सो ही सेज देयर आर एडवांटेजेस ऑब्वियसली इन द एडवांस, इन द ट्रांजिशन थ्रू मिडिल एज इनटू लेटर लाइफ, थ्रू द मिडिल एजेस टू लेटर लाइफ मीन्स टू टू द ओल्ड एज. And which are very seldom, very often, sometimes they are stated in a very sensible way. Sometimes, though not at all times, he says, sometimes only they are being stated in a sensible way. Otherwise, they are being told in a very mocking way or in a very silly manner. Generally, they are stated in a sentimental way. He says that sometimes, only very few times it happens that the things are being told in a very in a sensible manner. Otherwise, what happens? That they are being stated in a sentimental way, rather more often. कभी कभी ऐसा होता है कि एक sensible तरीके से, एक तर्कपूर्ण तरीके से, एक अच्छे तरीके से उन advantages की, उन benefits की बात होती है. Otherwise, generally, ज़्यादातर क्या होता है? They are being stated, they are being told in a sentimental way. उनको है ना एक मतलब भावनात्मक रूप से बताया जाता है, नॉट इन ए सेंसिबल वे, नॉट इन ए प्रैक्टिकल वे दे आर बीइंग स्टेटेड, दे आर बीइंग टोल्ड इन ए जनरल सजेशन दैट ओल्ड मैन आर इक्विप्ड विद ब्यूटीफुल स्नोवी बियर्ड्स लाइक फादर क्रिसमस. वट आर दैट सेंटिमेंटल वे, वट आर दो सेंटिमेंटल वेज ऑफ टेलिंग दीज थिंग्स आर वट दैट इन ए जनरल सजेशन, in a general estimation of thing, a general scenario is what? That in the old age, we are equipped, we are adorned, we have the facility to have a snowy beard like Father Christmas and rejoice in unfathomable wisdom like Nestor. Nestor is an old Greek leader at the War of Troy. He was the oldest of these Greeks. So he says, and two things which are generally associated and which are being told in a sentimental way, not in a sensible way, jinko ki ek bhavnatmak roop se bataya jata hai ki do cheeze, do benefits, do pleasures, do uplabdhiyan jo hame milti hain old age mein, wo kya hain? The snowy beards like Father Christmas, hum jo hai wo safed daadi jo hai wo hum adorn karte hain, wo hamare chehre pe aa jati hai, and we have an unfathomable wisdom. Unfathomable means which cannot be measured, itni gehri ki jisko hum naap nahi sakte hain, jiska hame anuman nahi hai ki wo kitni gehri wisdom hai. That so we have these two pleasures or these two properties to ourselves in the old age, that we have snowy beards and we have a store of wisdom. All this has caused the young people to be skeptical about the real advantages of the old people, and the true statement of those advantages sounds like a paradox. Now he comes to the point that these things which are being told about old age, which are being stated at the advantage of old age, like snowy beard and the store of wisdom, they are being told in such a way that this has caused the young people to be skeptical about the real advantages of the old people. The real advantages which the old people have, they are not being stated more often, and this thing has made the young people skeptical, doubtful about the advantages of old age. ये जो old age के advantages हैं, old age की जो benefits हैं, वो अक्सर जो है वो एक sentimental तरीके से बताए जाते हैं, ना कि एक sensible तरीके से, ना कि एक logical तरीके से बताए जाते हैं. And this causes the young man to be worried, to be doubtful, to be skeptical about the real advantages of old age. और ये जो चीज़ें ना जिस ढंग से इनको बताया जाता है, उनकी वजह से क्या होता है कि the old जो young people हैं, वो old age के बारे में संदेश रखते हैं, वो डाउटफुल होते हैं इसके बारे में कि व्हाट आर द रियल एडवांटेजेस ऑफ ओल्ड एज, एंड द ट्रू स्टेटमेंट ऑफ दोज एडवांटेजेस साउंड्स लाइक ए पैराडॉक्स. एंड दिस इज एज दिस इज माय मिशन एंड दिस इज व्हाट आई एम राइटिंग दिस पीस ऑफ राइटिंग, दैट इफ आई टेल द रियल एडवांटेजेस ऑफ ओल्ड एज टू द यंग पीपल, अगर मैं जो रियल एडवांटेजेज जो सच में प्राप्त होते हैं ओल्ड एज के बेनिफिट्स जो हैं, इफ़ आई टेल देम टू द यंग पीपल, देन दे विल साउंड लाइक ए पैराडॉक्स, दे विल साउंड लाइक जस्ट अपोजिट टू व्हाट इज़ बीइंग टोल्ड और व्हाट इज़ बीइंग बिलीव्ड सो फार. अब तक जो बताया जाता है, जैसा बिलीफ है, जैसा लोगों की मान्यता है, धारणा है कि ओल्ड एज में क्या बेनिफिट्स हैं एंड व्हाट द ओल्ड एज इज़ ऑल अबाउट, देन इट विल सीम पैराडॉक्सिकल. तो ये बिल्कुल ही जो है पैराडॉक्सिकल होगा, विरोधाभासी होगा जैसा उन्होंने अब तक सुन रखा है उससे. आई वुड नॉट से दैट ओल्ड मैन ग्रो वाइज, फॉर मैन नेवर ग्रो वाइज, एंड मैनी ओल्ड मैन रिटेन ए वेरी अट्रैक्टिव चाइल्डिशनेस एंड चीयरफुल इनोसेंस. नाउ द फर्स्ट थिंग विच ही कम्स इज दिस, बिकॉज द स्नोवी बियर्ड दैट इज ए फिजिकल अपीयरेंस, एंड नो डाउट देर इज नो कन्फ्यूटेशन, देर इज नो differences about this point, that yes, in the old age, with the growing of the age, we have grey hairs, है ना. So old age के साथ अगर हमारे बाल सफ़ेद हो रहे हैं, हमारी दाढ़ी सफ़ेद हो रही, that is a physical appearance, है ना. We can't move that to any place, है ना. But what about the second thing, the wisdom part of thing? He says, I would not say that old men grow wise. Main baat kabhi nahi kahunga that old men grow wise. Why? Because men never grow wise. This is the human nature, that we never grow wise. We say na, that we learn all our life, we keep mistaking all our life, we keep learning all our life, so we cannot grow wise. Hum kabhi bhi wise nahi ho sakte, buddhiman nahi ho sakte. And he says, and many men, old men, retain a very attractive childishness and cheerful innocence. And in reality, many of the old people, they retain, they hold that same childishness as is being held by the children, and they remain very cheerfully innocent. Means one thing is that innocence which irritates you, but they are very cheerfully innocent. Means they don't have any regret of this thing that they are innocent about anything. So that is the reality. Agar hum satyata ki baat karein, agar hum satya thing dekhein, jo reality dekhein, ग्राउंड रियलिटी जो होती है वो क्या होती है, मैनी एंड ओल्ड मैन आर इनोसेंट एंड दे आर वेरी हैप्पीली इनोसेंट. दे डोंट हैव एनी रिग्रेट, दे डोंट हैव एनी कंप्लेंट अबाउट दिस थिंग दैट दे डोंट नो द थिंग्स एंड दे आर नॉट वाइज. एल्डरली पीपल आर ऑफन मच मोर रोमांटिक देन यंगर पीपल एंड समटाइम्स इवन मोर एडवेंचरस हैविंग बिगन टू रियलाइज हाउ मैनी थिंग्स दे डोंट नो. दिस इज ऑफन टाइम्स some the elderly peoples are much more romantic. If we talk we label things na, that the young men are romantics and old men are not romantic. They are logical, they are reasonable and all those things. So he says that oftentimes this happens, that the old men are more romantic, more adventurous than the younger people, and sometimes they are even more adventurous, more interested in finding new things, more interested in doing new things. Why? Because they clearly know that what are the things which they do not know at the young age. We don't have the clear knowledge of this thing, that what we don't know and what we know. But at the passing of the age, at the passing of the time, we have realized obviously that what are the things which we do not know, and this makes the old men more romantic and more adventurous. They are more interested in trying new things, in doing new works. It is a true proverb, no doubt, which says there is no fool like an old fool. And he says it is a true proverb, no doubt, which says, ये जो proverb है जिसका जो ये कहती है, there is no fool like an old fool, because the old fool knows all his follies, he knows all his mistakes, he knows all his misleads, all his ignorances, all his abilities, he knows. So he says that this proverb which we might have heard at times, that there is no fool like an old fool, that is quite true. Because the old person, he knows all his follies, he knows all his mistakes. So there is no fool like an old fool. Perhaps there is no fool who is half so happy in his own fool's paradise. And he says, perhaps there is no fool who is half so happy in his own fool's paradise as an old man. Because every fool enjoys his foolishness at times. And every fool has his own fool's paradise, which he rejoices, which he enjoys when he looks back at his follies and his mistakes. However this may be, it is true that the advantages of maturity are not those which are generally asked, even praise of it. And when they are truly asked, they sound like an almost comic contradiction. He says, however this may be, though this may look like this, that the real advantages of maturity are not those which are generally asked, even in praise of it. He said, if we look at the things, or if we have a real analysis of the things of young and old age, then we will find out that the real advantages of maturity, even if they are being told in praise of maturity, then they are not those which are being told generally, and when they are truly asked, they sound like an almost comic contradiction. And he says, now I am going to narrate in the further paragraphs about the real advantages of maturity, and if we state them in a real manner, that what are the real advantages of maturity, then we will see that the real advantages of maturity are in a very comic contradiction to the reality or to the existing beliefs when they are being told. Na wo kare ki agar main reality mein state karun, reality mein main aapko unka ek real account prastut karun ki what are the real advantages of old age, then they will be in contradiction to the old age or the general belief of old age. Jaisa hum old age ka belief rakhte hain, jaisa hum old age ke bare mein एक धारणा जो रखते हैं, एक विश्वास जो रखते हैं कि दिस इज व्हाट हैपेंस इन ओल्ड एज, एंड इफ आई टेल यू द रियल अकाउंट ऑफ दीज बेनिफिट्स, दोज एडवांटेजेस ऑफ ओल्ड एज, देन दे विल ऑब्वियसली अपीयर टू बी कॉन्ट्राडिक्टी टू द रियलिटी और टू द बिलीफ्स ऑफ ओल्ड एज. सो दिस इज इट. थैंक्स.